What is endophthalmitis? Now, it's a big term, but it's a very, very scary term. Endophthalmitis is pus inside the eye, not outside the eye, not some discharge coming out. It's pus inside the eye. Now, we have seen patients come to us after cataract surgery saying they've completely lost vision. And it's not just the vision. Now they have severe pain, edema in the lids, and they're not able to move their eyes properly. They have developed severe endophthalmitis. The problem with this is if you do not treat it on time, it can result in total blindness. And not only blindness, it can cause complete shrinkage of the eye. That pus can even move on to the brain if you develop something called panophthalmitis, in which all the coats of the eyeball are inflamed and infected with pus. Now, how do we, first of all, diagnose a case of endophthalmitis? This is very common after cataract surgery. By common, I mean 1 in 1,000 cases. Now, the problem with endophthalmitis is it has happened because probably the lens which was inserted inside your eye was contaminated, or the fluid which was used during the cataract surgery was contaminated, or some issue with the equipment which was used. Now, this is really not the doctor's fault. This has happened because the pharmaceutical companies have provided stuff like this to use for the surgery. But don't worry about it. If you have developed a sudden drop in vision after your cataract surgery, rush to your retina specialist. The reason is, antibiotics can be injected inside your eye and your eye can be saved just in time. However, you must remember to go immediately. Now, what I recommend initially is something called an AC wash, which is you wash the front portion of the eye where we have started the surgery, and you give that tap for culture and sensitivity to see which bacterium is growing there, and you straight away inject the most common antibiotics inside the eye at the exact concentration. Your retina specialist will know what that is about, with a little bit of steroid. Now, it is also important to start systemic steroids. You have to start systemic steroids and systemic antibiotics, because there is an overall inflammation inside the eye which has to get controlled, and not just the pus. So this is one condition which is treated with intravitreal antibiotics and systemic steroids. Now, it is important sometimes to repeat the antibiotic. Now, some doctors feel if there is pus, you remove the pus. Anywhere in the body, if there's pus, you have to remove the pus. So immediately go in and operate. I definitely do not recommend surgery immediately. The reason is you are removing the vitreous gel inside the eye. You're not removing just pus. You're removing a substance inside the eye which you were born with, the vitreous. Now, when do you remove this vitreous? Only if there is absolutely no other option. So what I recommend is you give the correct dose of antibiotics, you wait for 1 day, probably even 2 days, that is about 48 hours, and repeat the antibiotics. Because when you repeat the antibiotics, you're reaching the correct concentration of antibiotic within the eye. And most of the time, 95% and plus of the time, you will see a response, but it does not happen immediately. Don't expect immediate results. The first thing you will see is the patient's pain dramatically comes down. If the pain has come down, your injection is working. Do not look at the vision instantly. You wait for at least a month to slowly see vision coming back. It can slowly recover to 1 meter vision, and then 2200, and eventually vision slowly starts coming back. If you jump in and operate, the chances of your tearing the vitreous, tearing the retinal periphery, causing a retinal detachment, are very high in such cases. And I do not recommend immediate surgery, though it is a part of various guidelines, but I have seen patients recover with just this. The only reason they could possibly require surgery is if it is a fungal endophthalmitis. Now, this is a very rare type of endophthalmitis, which happens much later. It does not happen immediately after cataract surgery. It can take a week or 2 weeks, sometimes 6 weeks to develop. And the appearance of the retina, the appearance of the vitreous, is totally different from a frank, purulent endophthalmitis caused by bacteria.